You're spinning, and I'm spinning, and the Earth is spinning, and the sun is spinning, and the solar system is spinning. Everything is spinning. But why? Hey everybody, thank you for watching DNews today. I'm Trace. You might remember from our How Fast is the Universe Moving video that you are moving really fast right now. For example, the Earth is rotating around its axis at 1,040 miles an hour. Planets rotate. That's what they do, right? But then science comes along and is all like, why? And once you start thinking about it, it's actually pretty staggering. To figure it out, we have to go back to the beginning. 4.5 billion years ago, our solar system began to form from clouds of helium and hydrogen. It looked kind of like a nebula. As the clouds of gas moved and undulated through the universe, some of them were denser and some were thinner. Something, perhaps a nearby supernova, they think, caused the gases to begin to coalesce. And as the gravity of these particles increased, they began to fall toward each other and to spin. Funnily enough, every time this happens, the spin seems to rotate in the same direction, at least in our solar system, the counterclockwise direction. There's no up in space, of course, but if you think about the angular movement of the spin as a forward direction, then most things like Earth, Mars, and the Sun all rotate counterclockwise. Because they're all conserving their angular momentum, they continue to do so. As the gases continued to gravitate toward each other, constantly moving and falling, they formed a tossed pizza dough shape, a ball in the middle slowly expanding outward into a disk. This is a shape that we see most often in the universe because of the laws of physics. As interstellar clouds rotate and collapse onto themselves, they fragment. This is according to Scientific American. And then those smaller parts collapse again and again, and over the next few hundred million years, all that gas gathers and fuses into suns, planets, asteroids, and eventually, after a lot more time, you and me. All the while, the angular momentum of the original cloud is maintained, and that original gaseous angular momentum set the stage for all the rotation to follow. Inertia now keeps it going. However, it is slowing over time. A day in 100 years will be 2 milliseconds longer than a day now, but ultimately, we'll all keep spinning, unless something big smacks into us, of course. Strangely, Venus rotates clockwise, opposite of everybody else, and we're not entirely sure why. Either the axis of the planet was flipped upside down at some point, or it slowed its rotation counterclockwise, stopped, and then began to rotate the opposite way, possibly due to its dense atmosphere and closeness to the sun. It's not the only weirdo out there either. Uranus was knocked on its side, so her rotation is all screwed up. Even on a macro level, everything in the universe is moving and spinning. But galaxies relative to Earth spin both clockwise and counterclockwise. There doesn't seem to be any standardization there. Though spiral galaxies do tend to spin with their arms trailing behind them, if you will. But even that isn't a hard and fast rule. In 2002, the Hubble spotted a galaxy named NGC 4622, very creative, whose arms lead her rotation. But they believe that it's because that galaxy interacted with another galaxy. Sounds kind of hot. In the end, everything in the universe is, of course, moving and spinning. Energy must be preserved over time, so when a figure skater spins with his arms in, he will spin faster, but with his arms out, like a galaxy that grows, it moves slower. Simple physics, but it does operate on that galactic level. Does a science question in you have your head spinning? Go ahead down into the comments and ask us. And while you're clicking around down there, check out our other show, Test Tube. It's like DNews, but for world affairs, politics, global stories, it's pretty amazing.
Another agreement called the Moon Treaty followed in 1979 as a supplement to the Outer Space Treaty and prohibited the use of the moon for any hostile acts, including installing military bases or testing weapons. However, this treaty was not signed by the United States, Russia, China, or Japan, all countries with the ability to go into space.
And make sure you keep coming back for more DNews. Thanks for watching.